Here we are in 1517, gathered by the castle Catholic Church with our friend, Martin Luther. Here the lad is, stapling his 95 theses to the door, spurring on what we now know today as the Protestant Reformation. Here we are a few years later in the presence of the Holy Roman Emperor, Charles V. Charles was a man of Catholic faith, and was quite perturbed by the spread of Protestantism. This rise of Protestantism weakened his influence, and made him quite angry at the state of affairs.
My influence is oh so small, and I need to bring back my power and Catholicism once and for all.
However, before anyone could get a little too silly, the Diet of Augsburg took place, an open forum between Catholics and Protestants to discuss differences.
Hey gang, I don't like you, but I want a discussion.
Here's what's wrong with the Catholic Church.
No.
Judging by this unfortunate encounter, it was obvious that no conclusion would be met between the two groups. And thus, Protestant principalities within the Holy Roman Empire took the initiative to form religious alliances to protect against Charles V.
Hey bestie, we need to protect the Protestant faith. Do you want to become allied with me?
Yes.
Thus, the Schmalkaldic League was formed. While the Schmalkaldic League was being formed, Charles V went along on his own agenda, creating alliances between other entities such as France and the Ottoman Empire. The devious little man, his main goal of these alliances was eventually to gain support from the papacy in Italy to start a religious war to reinstate Catholicism once and for all.
There's like gonna be a war, and like I need cash. Can you provide me cash?
Yes.
Thus, the Pope pledged to financially support Charles V in a religious war against the Protestants. The goofy little Charles then goes on to align himself with other Catholic provinces within the HRE such as Bavaria, in order to secure the W.
Okay gang, I'm about to go to war. Can you not get in my way?
Yes, King. We'll stay in the neutral territory.
Charles V was now ready for action. Within the Schmalkaldic League, efforts to advance their agenda post-failed Diet of Augsburg were brewing. And so, Schmalkaldic troops began to occupy the town of Fussen. It was apparent that the Schmalkaldic League wanted to instigate battle, however, the Imperial Army wished to not engage. Thus, the move of the Schmalkaldic troops led the Imperial Army to flee to Bavaria. For the next few months, the Schmalkaldic troops were constantly seeking a battle without trying to make the first move, while the Imperial Army was trying to not instigate any fighting. However, out of nowhere the absolute stud Maurice of Saxony, Duke of the Saxony province, and his bestie Archduke Ferdinand decide to invade the electorate of Saxony in order to gain more territory with their greedy selves.
Brother, let us commence our conquest to gain more territory.
Alright.
Oh no. The poor leader of the Schmalkaldic League, John Frederick, was also the elector of Saxony. Thus, he had to help his province out by enlarging his militia, abandoning his efforts of the Schmalkaldic League, leading to its dissolution. In other news, Charles V was so happy, he now had the means to penetrate the Holy Roman Empire with his faith.
Alright, the provinces of Wittenberg-Palatine and the Electorate Saxony must remain neutral.
This all led to the sad sack of a man, John Frederick, signing the capitulation of Wittenberg. Essentially, he had given up. The war had been lost. As if things couldn't get worse for the Protestants, Charles V gets a little too silly and goes against one of his promises. Originally, Charles agreed not to imprison a Lutheran prince, Landgrave Philip, throughout his tirade. He was in a goofy mood and decided to imprison him anyway, along with John Frederick. Here are their last words.
Falling, dreaming, talking, in your sleep, I know you want to cry all night.
Amid this godforsaken prison, only hold my body and never my mind.